I'm Bunny Barnes, and welcome to Fer Friday at 4, number 60. Wow, who we got here today? Dave Mason, I know, is the first person in the room. All the way from Scotland, he made it first. Bruce McNeil, hey. Terry St. James, up in Canada. Slim, that what a fun show that Slim Adelman just had. Steve Adelman, I shared that, so you have to go and check it out. TV themes. Warren says he'll check it later, watch it later. Hey, Toby, thank you for joining. Debbie, you made it. Debbie Freed. Yeah, it's pretty stormy around here, isn't it? Pam Zappardino, Rich Fowler, John Montanez, all the way from the West Coast. Thank you, John. And is Lawrence on today, I guess? That's why you're saying Lawrence Juber? Yeah, I think he's doing his Finger Buster Friday today, so we'll check that. Michael Tiersen, thanks for joining. It's a pleasure to have you here. So this first tune that I want to do today, it might not really be ready for prime time, but I wanted to do it today anyway. It's a ballad written by Joseph Brooks in 1977 and originally recorded by Casey Sissek, but was best known by the cover version recorded by Debbie Boone, who's the daughter of Pat Boone. It held the number one spot on the Billboard Hot 100 chart for 10 consecutive weeks and topped the Record World Magazine Top 100 Singles chart for 13 weeks. The song earned Brooks a Grammy Award for Song of the Year, an Academy Award, and Golden Globe for Best Original Song. Boone's recording became the biggest single of the 70s, setting a new Billboard Hot 100 record for the most weeks spent at number one. She won a Grammy in 1978 for Best New Artist and the American Music Award for Favorite Pop Single. It was ranked number 7 on the Billboard Hot 100 All-Time Singles between 1958 and 2008. Pretty cool, number 7. This was my mom's favorite song, and she always wanted me to sing it to her, and I never really got the chance to do it. This is when I was singing. And so I learned the instrumental of it so I could play it for her. And I want to send it out today to all the people who are hurting in Texas and to Rhonda Scott Merrick, because I know she's really hurting. Hey, Jan Anderson, anybody guess what it is yet? Yep, Pam Zappardino guessed it. You light up my life. Hey, Mike Verbeck, Dennis Keller, thanks for coming. So it might not be quite ready for prime, but I'm doing it anyway. You light up my life. Thank you. light of my life too, honey. Thank you. Thanks so much. So I want to encourage you to share this on Facebook, so it'll be on replay. It'll be on replay on mine as well. I will check all the comments later. I want to thank Toby Simmons for advertising me on the West Coast. If you use PayPal or Venmo, I so appreciate it, but it's not necessary. If you do use PayPal, please be careful not to enable PayPal protection. There's a little blue thing that says change, and change that to friends, and then PayPal doesn't get a cut. I want to say hi to my invisible friends. I know Linda Worcester's here. Kit Sarikaku might be too, with Rosemary Ross and Bob Zaltzberg and Craig Patrun and Daryl Anderson, maybe Joel Bijet or Richard Saslow, and any others that I missed. If you're watching this live and I missed your name, you might be invisible. Let me know. We've had some great lives over the last couple days. Alex Bevan did one at 3:30 yesterday. That's shared on my newsfeed, as well as Mark McNeil's Blues Club. And we just had Warren Bendler did a fabulous set, some great tunes. And Slim Adelman, Steve Adelman, also back on my newsfeed. Slim did one with all these TV themes that he wanted you to guess what they were, kind of like what I'm doing with Guess the Tune, and Name That Tune. And it was really, it's really fun. So I want to go back and watch the rest of his, and that's shared on my page too. Lawrence Juber might be doing his Finger Buster Friday today too. I don't know, Toby, let us know. Raleigh, since Raleigh's not going to be on this Sunday, he's doing a special live stream tonight at 7 p.m. So Raleigh Brown, check him out tonight at 7 p.m. And tomorrow morning, Dakota Tabe Hull, he's back from his trips. He's on a guitar day. He's on Saturday morning at 11. Tim Eady is doing his Sleepy Time Tunes at 6 p.m. from Ireland. And then Raleigh, I guess, will be back. He might be back Monday. I'm not sure about that. But definitely Wednesday at 3. Sunday, we have Anthony Snape in Australia and Andrew at 6. And Anthony Clark from Canada at 7. And then Muriel Anderson. Lawrence might be back with Moody Monday. I don't know. Muriel might be back again also Monday at 7 p.m. So check those out. Don't forget Meredith Axelrod and Craig Ventresco. They're on usually Sunday's brunch and Monday through Thursday at 11. I'm not sure about their Saturday night one. If you're in the area, I hope you'll come out. I'm back at Maxwell's on Main in Doylestown. They call it Mom's. Upstairs from noon to 3, it's Brunch with Bunny. So if you're in the area, I hope that you'll come by. I'd like to be back there, and the more people that come, the better chance I have of coming back. And I do have a possible gathering here next Friday, but I'm thinking they can just be my live audience because I want to do my twofer. So expect me back on next Friday for number 61, and I hope to see you there for that, and also at Maxwell's on Main on Saturday, on Sunday at noon to 3. This next tune was a popular tune from 1930. The words were written by Hoagy Carmichael and the melody by Sidney Arredin. It's considered a jazz and pop standard and was used in the 1934 film with the same name. It was recorded by Hoagy Carmichael and his orchestra, also by Benny Goodman and his orchestra, with Helen Forrest singing it. Louis Armstrong did it. The Mills Brother did it. That's a big hint. And even Merle Travis did it. Chet Atkins as well. This past Tuesday, we lost an amazing guitarist by the name of Tom Bresch. And Tom Bresch was the son of Merle Travis. And he was an incredibly gifted guitarist and an amazing videographer. He would do a video every year at the Chet Atkins Convention, CAS. And I was lucky enough to be in one of Tom's videos. And I feel very blessed to have had that opportunity. And he passed away from cancer this past Tuesday. And so since his dad played it, I'd like to play this in his memory today. It's one of those tunes with a seldom heard verse that you never hear, and you only know the chorus. So I'm not going to tell you what it is. I'm going to let you guys guess what it is. I can't actually see the chat right now. It's, there we go. Hey, Dave Nardi, let me check this. Rodney Wright, Sartorius, hello, grüß dich. Arlene, you made it. Thanks, Steve. I appreciate that. Thanks, Slim. Diane Reeves Pack. I think I got you all. Thank you, guys. I thank you so much for the good comments. I'll read them later, I promise. So maybe you can guess this. It's a seldom heard verse, and I won't tell you the name. You can guess it. Lady Mary, you guys got it.
Thanks, honey.
Yeah, you guys got it. Pam was the first one to get it. Yeah, Donna Greenberg got it too. Hey, Donna, thanks for joining. So, yeah, it's a fun tune. Hey, Annette Worley, thanks for coming in. Bright side on a cloudy day. Thank you. And so, yeah, it's pretty dim out there. So thank you. Yeah, Up the Lazy River. Man, what a great old tune. And I love that verse. I like lazy rivers. Oh man, it's a really good one. It was really hard to find that verse. You had to find the sheet music. There's only one guy, Fred Sokolov, does it on YouTube. But all the other old recordings, none of them have the verse. It was really really a challenge to find that one. But I really, really love that tune. So thank you all for coming today. Letting the guitar be my voice heals my soul, and I hope that my music makes you happy. That's my goal in life. My CD is being mixed now. I'm working on the cover. I'm hoping to have it released by July. So you guys will be one of the first to know. Yeah. So I'm hoping. Thanks, Dave Nardi. Appreciate it. Again, be careful out there because, you know, it's still out there and people are still getting sick. Our hearts go out to the people in Texas. Something's got to be done. Yeah, that's all I'm going to say. I won't go on my soapbox. I love y'all. Stay safe. Hope to see you next week for 2 for Friday at 4, number 61. Take care. Bye-bye.